Hey, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas room. I'll be right back.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hey, welcome, welcome, welcome. I've been waiting for you to come and join me because I'm making a new video today just for you. I want to tell you something special. Before we start, let me do and conduct the right business. I need to use the right white, which you can get in the link down below. And I started the camera rolling before this video, and I have another video hiding somewhere called Behind the Scenes. So you can see what I did before I started this video and what I'm going to do after I turn this video off. I'll keep the camera rolling. So that's going to be called the Behind the Scenes, and the title of it will be Why Mirrorless Cameras Are Broken for Wedding Photographers and Event Photographers. And I'm going to show you something special. So the links to the Behind the Scenes video is going to be down below. It's cheap. It's a dollar or two. It's better than using Patreon for people that want to support me. I want to give you something. So I'm just giving you more video, more of me. All right. So if you're, going to buy something for $1.50 and you want to tip, my channel, that's why I make the behind the scenes videos. So enough of that. Let's get rolling with this one. So I did the right white. All right. Now, what I want to talk about is why mirrorless cameras have basically messed over wedding photographers and event photographers, okay, on a flash that you put into your hot shoe. This is an example of one. That's a Godox. This is a Canon one. This one has a diffuser on it, one of my diffusers at petergregg.com. It's designed special in 2002, 2003, and I've been selling them for all these years. This is the large version, and it's designed to diffuse the light. Okay, so this is not an explanation of this, but all of these have this little red area. You buy this as a an added flash for pictures. All right, back to what I'm going. All right, there's a red area, and this shoots out a light. All of them have it. See, this one has it, this one has it, my Nikons have it. I didn't bring the Nikon in here because I don't have a Nikon body to show you with. And these shoot out a red light, and they call it, many people call it, an infrared light, a focus assist infrared light. It's not infrared, but it is red, and it projects a pattern. So now you've got all these new cameras that are mirrorless, and these mirrorless cameras, guess what? They have no mirror. Who would have thought that a mirrorless camera would have no mirror? So if I take off the lens and I hold it up, and if I'm smart enough to zoom in at this point, I would show you that this has no mirror. You see directly into the sensor. If I stick my finger in there, I can actually damage my sensor. So now the cameras before this, okay, for instance, this is an old camera. Really old digital camera, okay? This is a Rebel XTI from Canon, all right? And it has a mirror. If I take the lens, you will see the mirrorless. That's why it's called a DSLR. Digital lens reflex camera. The reflex means it's a reflection because they doesn't mean there's a mirror, okay? But it means there's a reflection. So now if I take the flash unit and I put it on here, all right, and I lock it in. This is, what is this? This is the 580 EX2 from Canon, okay? And if I turn this camera on, now what I'm gonna have to do, this is gonna be a little weird. So this video is gonna be a little awkward, okay? I'm gonna turn the lights off, all right? So what I'm gonna do is this is how I pre-focus. I'm using the GH4 because I'm using all my other cameras that are out here. Some of them are mine and some of them are not. The GH4 is my camera. So I'm using that camera because I'm going to use these cameras to make demonstration stuff for you. All right. So what I normally do with the GH4 is I put this where I'm going to stand and I pre-focus. Okay. But now I'm going to use it a little bit differently. I'm going to put it over here. and hopefully you'll be able to see it. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you that the mirrorless cameras will not focus on that when the lights are off. So you say to me, but Peter, these cameras, like let's say the RP, it has a little light built into it, and that light will just blast, and this way it'll focus in pitch black. But remember, this video is for photographers, event photographers, and wedding photographers. And if I blasted a little red light into your eyes all night at the equivalent of about 100 watts, like a flashlight, or maybe even a stronger flashlight, you've seen them, they're orange, they're green, okay? And it helps them to focus in pitch black. No lights. So tell me, where would you have a place where it would be pitch black or very, very super dark? That's the number one thing. Where would you have a place where it's very super dark? There's a lot of activity. You are most likely being paid to record this event. And you need to come home with good pictures, okay? You can't come home with crappy pictures, especially if they paid you for this. All right, a wedding. The clue is in the title, all right? So what happens at the reception? Somebody there decides they want beautiful atmosphere. So they lower the lights. All right, so I've got the cameras lined up here, and I'm going to work in the dark. So that's what's going to make it clumsy. But I'm going to try to keep talking because you're not going to be able to see anything. All right, so I'm going to shove the desk out of the way. All right, and I'm going to go back here, and I'm going to turn the Christmas lights off. And I'm going to make it so it's dark in here. Darker than a reception hall. Because reception halls get really dark. All they've got is candles and very low lighting because they want the atmosphere. And then the DJ is going to come in with super loud music that just kills your ears, you know. And then he's got the flashing strobes, which is making you dizzy. So that's why they got the liquor up there to help calm your nerves. And then you're just happy in la la land and you're having a good time. All right, so what I'm going to demonstrate. All right, what am I going to demonstrate? All right, I'm going to demonstrate being able or not being able to take a picture in pitch black darkness. So what I'm thinking about is how I'm going to do this, okay, so that you could see what's going on. So what I'm going to do is let's turn off the lights. I might have to do this a couple of times. We'll turn off that light. We'll turn off this light. Oh, crap. I can't see what the heck I'm doing. Okay. All right. Now, can you see that red light? It's on. Okay, let me turn the lights on again so you remember what you're looking at, all right? This is my focus board. I moved it back here, and hopefully you're going to see a red pattern, okay, that is going to flash on here. Now, that red pattern is going to come from the red light that's built in to the external flash unit. Okay, this is an external flash unit. You've got to buy them separate. Each camera company has their external flash units. They don't come with my diffuser on top. You got to buy that from a guy named Peter Gregg down in Miami, Florida, and he sells them on his website. All right, so the smarter people are going to be diffusing their light in some fashion. They're going to buy a diffuser, the wedding photographers. There's a lot of popular ones, Flip It, Gary Fong's Light Sphere. There's the magnet stuff. And then Peter Gregg has this one that I designed for myself and use it all the time, okay? And there's a reason. I'll make a separate video for that. So now I'm going to turn the lights off again. Now, look in this area, kind of keep in mind where it is on the screen, because you're going to look for a red pattern. It just blinks. It does not turn on and stay on. Okay, so now I'm trying to aim it. You see that? Every time I press the shutter, I could take a picture, okay? So I could take a picture anywhere in this room. I could take a picture of the couch. I could take a picture of the floor. I could take pictures anywhere, and they're going to be perfectly focused because that red light, let me blank this off, that red light that you see is the pattern, okay? So if I aim this at the camera, okay, you see the red light of what it's doing? That's what that red light looks like. And it would put that stripe of red light like that on my body. And it happens so fast. See how it just goes on and goes off just for a split second? I am not turning that on and off, okay? The camera is doing it, but it's on just long enough so I can actually take a picture. And I could take a picture anywhere in this room because it's pitch black, all right? So now, let me turn the lights on because I'm a little worried about falling down because there's no lighting in here, okay? Now I'm gonna turn this off. And I'm going to turn this camera off. So I showed you with an old camera because this is projecting a professional type of red light and not the orange or the green one that looks like somebody turned a stinking flashlight on in your face. By the end of the night, if you do that, the people are going to hate you. Let's take a popular camera. Let's take the RP. I've got the RP, okay? So I'm going to take my flash unit, and this is a pretty high-end one. The newest one is a 600. This is a model 580. So we're just one model behind. I'm going to turn the flash on, and I'm going to turn the camera on. Okay. And I'm going to turn the lights off, and I'm going to tell you when I'm pushing the shutter down. And I'm going to keep talking because now I'm feeling my way back around here. Okay. Now I'm pushing the shutter down, and nothing is happening. Now I push the shutter about 7 or 8 times. So what's happening? Why am I showing you this, number one? And then number two, what am I trying to demonstrate? I'm trying to demonstrate that the mirrorless cameras make it when you get into a darker atmosphere, a restaurant, a ballroom where the wedding reception would be, anything that you know you would need to be able to get the shot. Over and over and over, get the shot. The mirrorless cameras don't let you do that. So the Canon, I just showed you, you can't do it. There's none of the Canon mirrorless. So they've got the M50, they've got the M series completely. Then they've got the RP, then they've got the R. And they're probably gonna be coming out with a 1DX type because the R is like a 5D Mark IV, okay? Well, just for the heck of it, let's try it again with this guy, all right? So this is the Panasonic. I know already that it's not going to work, okay? So I'm going to turn the light off. You can see, okay? Okay, now there's the orange light. Okay, see the orange light? Now look at the brightness of the orange light. If you were going to put that into somebody's eyes all night long, okay, so now if I cover that orange light and I press the shutter, press the shutter, press the shutter, press the shutter, press the shutter. Can you see it lighting up on my finger in there? Okay, I'm covering it so it doesn't get it. It can't take the shot because it's a mirrorless camera. And they have all the professional flash equipment that you could buy, okay, like this one. And it's got all this built into it, all right, the infrared light, and it's not infrared, even though we call it that, it's just a habit, all right? You can't use it. So now I'm gonna show you a little trick that is, I don't wanna say it's a secret, but I'll tell you the truth, it took me forever to discover it, all right? So here's the Sony. It does not fire the red light, okay? Now, here's the secret. You ready to learn a little secret, okay? If you buy this, you can buy it for the Sony only, okay? I have not discovered this on any other one. And it comes with a trigger. That's all it does, is it will trigger the flash units. So if I can get it in there, all right? And it has the little red light here to help with the focus assist, because the focus assist is so important that they built it into the trigger, and this is not the only one, all right? So now watch here when I put this radio trigger on. If I can turn everything on and make it look like I know what the heck I'm doing, turn this on, turn the light off, and let's see. Okay, can you see how it's projecting a pattern? So I can actually take a picture because it'll focus anytime that it needs to focus. I can take a picture in pure pitch black, and I can take a picture at you and it'll focus. So this will allow it to focus the camera. It happens instantly, and I can just take the picture of basically anything I want anywhere in the room. And that allows me to use the focus assist. Let's turn the lights back on, okay? I'm worried about tripping and falling down, and I'm going to turn the lights on the tree to make the room look like its normal room again. I know you could hear me, so I tried to talk all the way through the dark, all right? So that this way that I didn't want you to get scared. So I didn't want you to get all upset and get scared, so I kept talking to you all the way through the dark, okay? All right. So that's the trick to use the mirrorless camera, only the Sony, and only with this radio trigger. If you try to duplicate the same exact thing by putting the flash that comes with it, it won't work. It will not fire the focus assist light. Like when, as soon as I get a camera, the first thing I do is I turn off the beep, number one, and then number two, I turn off that stinking bright light that everybody goes like, okay, and it's like announcing. And they all have them built in, even the Sony. This is like a professional level camera, and it will fire that nice bright light right in your eyes. I gotta get it to a dark spot, okay? And that's like, here, let me fire a flashlight in your eyes over and over and over. Turn the flashlight on, turn the flashlight off. By the end of the night, you're not hiring me to do your daughter's wedding, and you're not going to recommend me for somebody's wedding. So that's what I wanted to point out. They need to fix that. All right, so that's what this video is about. All right, so that's it. Not too long. I just wanted to show you what's wrong with mirrorless cameras and why, if I was going to shoot weddings today, I probably would get the 1DX Mark II from Canon. And if you say, oh, that's a heavy camera, all right, then I probably would go with the D850. Those are regular cameras that are DSLRs, okay, and they will work with the focus assist lights because I would be shooting in those type of areas where I need to get the money shot. I need it to focus. I need it to focus accurately, quickly, and not blind the people as I'm firing 2,000 to 3,000 shots in an evening. Yes, that's what I come home with, 2,000 to 3,000 shots and sometimes more. So, you know, that's why professional photography is heavy duty stuff. All right, that's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Catch the show notes, catch the behind the scenes video in the link down below. That's how you help support the channel. By giving me $1.50 a cup of coffee, I send you the behind the scenes for this video. All right, so that's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Catch you later. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.